So hi everyone, my name is Tom Knostenbergs. I'm co-founder at Master Packager, and I have been packaging applications and building products for application packagers for more than a decade. My goal is to make application management easier and more affordable. In 2014, I worked as a full-time application packager. I sit at large desk and I had two monitors. On one monitor, I had a VMware workstation opened with three plus virtual machines running, one for application evaluation, one for packaging, and one for testing. On second monitor, I had a Word document. It had a very extensive step-by-step guide how to install this particular application that customers wanted for me to package and make it as a silent install package. It had instructions how to manually install it, how to disable updates, how to add some specific configuration, remove pop-ups, and all that stuff for application packagers to do. And as it was fairly a complicated application, I struggled to package it. And it took me almost all day to figuring it out. And as I was finishing up, something unexpected happened. My virtual machine, VMware process just stopped working. I lost all my work. And I felt like pain in my chest and confusion and disappointment. How this could happen? And turns out there was a specific reason why it happened. Internally, deployment specialist got the new VMware workstation version available, and he wanted to deploy it for all packaging team. So he did. He just took that installer and used the silent switch and pushed to all packagers without packaging, without testing, without wrapping. When it was triggered, it detected there is running processes that stopped it from installing. And of course, it killed these processes to finish installing. We knew that this kind of deployment can stop employees to do their job, as I was trying to do my job. And this is why when we do packaging for different organizations, we always use PowerShell Deploy Toolkit to wrap this package. So for those who don't know what PowerShell Deploy Toolkit is, it's a solution based on PowerShell with specified functions, currently owned by PatchMyPC, actively developed, open sourced, with a great community, and thousands of organizations use this for their packages. So there is no reason to not choose this. And for end users, make sure that all the installed requirements are there. For example, if the end user is in presenting mode, like I am right now, it shouldn't install anything at this point, right? Next lets you defer the installation if you are not ready to allow anything to install on your computer. And you can specify how many times you can let users to defer it. And of course, it can detect if there is some conflicting applications running and inform user to save their work before installation continues. Localization and branding helps deployment make familiar for the end users and makes it the user experience much, much better. For IT pros, there's one big reason why to use this, and it is to standardize their packages. So onboarding new team members makes it much easier. As well, troubleshooting is improved, as you know, for example, where to find the log files, as they are always in the one place. Knowing all this is nice, and we use PowerShell AppDeploy Toolkit for all our packages, but we find out ourselves in situations like this. We use a third-party PowerShell editor, like Visual Studio Code, for example, to make the PS1 file editing faster and better. We found out ourselves looking too many times into documentations for the same problem when we try to solve it. And we used excellent Discord community for for PowerShell Deploy Toolkit and asked the help there and used Google, of course. And it took too much time as we wanted to it. And we found out that software could improve this. And this is why we created Master Wrapper. And essentially what Master Wrapper is, it's a user-friendly interface for a PowerShell Deploy Toolkit package creation. With the standardized packaging flow, you are not missing some important details when filling out the package. And as there are multiple automations built through the software, you just simply gain more time to package more. Another thing is that PowerShell Deploy Toolkit combines all the important packaging metadata into one place. What we found out is that we can actually use that benefit of PowerShell Deploy Toolkit wrapping and add there as well metadata for deployments solutions like Intune. That would be a logo, description, and detection key. So all the information in one place. I created this high-level flow, how the packaging really looks like. It all starts with application installer from the vendor that you want to understand how you really want to package it. For that, we created Master Packager Toolbox. It's a software with different utilities, and one of the utilities is called Installed Apps. And Installed Apps lets you see what actually is installed by that vendor installer. And from there, you can actually see if there is an MSI or EXE and where this MSI is available. Most common packaging types are either vendor deployment solution, where you use some silent switches, or if there's no silent switch for EXE available, you use Master Repackager to convert EXE into MSI. Or if you have an MSI, you just use Master Packager to create MST file. And as a last step for this packaging process, where you have a ready package that you know how to install silently, uninstall silently, you wrap it into PowerShell AppDeploy Toolkit. And for that, you can use Master Wrapper that makes all that process easier. When you have a PowerShell Deploy Toolkit package ready, now we have built out functionality inside the Master Packager Toolbox, where with one click, you can get the Intune win file and then upload to Intune. And using Master Packager Toolbox, it will be visibly faster than using Intune portal. So this is the process. And now let's look on Master Wrapper in more detail. So when you open Master Wrapper, there is this general page where you can drag and drop your main installer. Either it's an MSI with MST file or EXE, and it will extract all the necessary data for the PowerShell Deploy Toolkit, like name, version, and so on. Extra thing what we do is we extract the logo from that installer. Another thing, you can add description manually stating what this application actually is. And all these things will be used for later on when you upload to the Intune. Next, you can fill out some deployment settings and as well to set out detection registry key. And it's important that logo and description and detection registry keys is done during the packaging. Because imagine now as a deployment specialist, you have to find out what is the real logo for this application, what this application really is, what kind of description is the correct one, and how should I correctly detect it? It's too late. This should be done during the packaging, and deployment specialist's only job should be to think about to which groups is package deployed to. Next, we look on main actions. And main actions states what kind of installation will happen, as well uninstallation and repair. All you need to do is drag and drop the installers you want to execute inside this view. And it will pre-fill all the execution command lines for you, as well for the uninstall and repair. And for uninstall, we even go extra mile and add the comments so you can understand what is this product code that actually uninstalls. Next, there is this pre-actions that is, again, PowerShell AppDeploy Toolkit functionality built for you. And from here, you can enable and disable it really easily. One thing that saves you a tremendous time is specifying which processes to be closed. If you have a larger application, let's say with 20 shortcuts, it will take you around like 15 minutes to find out all the processes you wanted to detect and close if they are running. But if you use master wrapper in the main actions using MSI, we in the background opened MSI, find out all the shortcuts, the target exe, and take these exe names and put here for you. Next, there is these post actions, again, that you can easily configure things that you want to do when the installation, uninstallation, or repair command lines and their process. One of the most important things when doing application management is to make sure that all the previous versions are removed. We use PowerShell App Deploy Toolkit built-in functionality. It is really great. However, it's too complicated for us. We look too many times into documentation, and if it's a bit too complicated, we have to do more testing to see if we are not making some mistakes. So we did even harder job, a user interface for it. So you don't have to use documentation for it, and you do not make some typos or mistakes. Currently, we offer three main actions here. So either you remove the previous version by MSI product code, MSI name, or exe command line stating where the exe will be located and what kind of silent uninstallation command lines it should be used to uninstall it. And anyone from your team knowing these basic details can fill out this form and have the upgrade done. Here is an example where you can add remove MSI using product name, select the name, filter out specific conditions. So you are removing all older versions and not removing something that you don't want to. When you work with more specific, complicated applications, you may find out that you need some specific PowerShell code or specific rarely used PowerShell Deploy Toolkit function that we haven't built out the UI for it. You can create snippets for these functionalities. So how does it work? On the top corner, you see the button Script Explorer. You open it and then you create a snippet. You fill out the form, selecting name, prefix by which you will find that snippet, add the description, and then the code itself. It uses TextMate snippet syntax that Visual Studio Code itself uses. And if you have already built out such snippets, you can use this in master wrapper. And when that is done, you can use this in script editor. We have as well built-in snippets for you. But when you use the script editor here in the next section, it uses IntelliSense. And here, when you type in, for example, firewall exception, you see that there is this white box that you just enter it and you have that code displayed here. Of course, different organizations have differently configured their PowerShell Deploy Toolkit. They have either already existing templates, or if they are new, they would create their own template with their own branding or some specific toolkit configuration, as you can see here in the left menu configuration. This is all main PowerShell Deploy Toolkit configuration added here with the master packager logo. And then when you have filled out all your configuration, you can save it as a template or load your own template if you have already built on. Select the name and select the location. And similarly, like for the Script Explorer, you can save this location into shared location for all your team. So every time you update the template, when you create new snippet, all your team actually can see that and use this. So with every snippet and template update, all your team gets better. Now, when you have the ready package, of course, you want to upload it to, for example, to Intune. Right click on the deploy application exe, and you have the context menu for PowerShell Deploy Toolkit to Intune Win. That button will generate Intune Win file. Then open Master Packager Toolbox. utility called Intune, and upload, just select that Intune win file here, and it's ready to upload. Before uploading, we of course want to for you to review if everything is correct. But however, if you used master wrapper, all the necessary data is there, and you just click button upload to Intune. Fun fact, this is multiple times faster than using Intune portal to do it. You will feel that if you have gigabytes of application packages, using Intune, you will again save, using Master Packager Toolbox, you will save a lot of time. We are working on a few cool functionality like code signing. Some organizations want to code sign all their scripts. So that will be possible with upcoming versions of Master Packager. Script detection is one of the things our customers are asking. We are working on that as well. A file manager to easily add new installations. And we will build out functionality to find easier all the PowerShell Deploy Toolkit functionalities and variables. So at the end of the day, with Master Wrapper, you improve packaging process. You just simply package faster and upload to Intune faster with sharing templates and snippets. Every time you introduce new functionality, your whole team gets better. And the main reason we all do that is to make our organization and users love our packages and applications. So if you want to learn more, download the Master Wrapper from our website and subscribe to our newsletter where you will learn more. That's it from me. Thank you for your time.